Welcome to Mojato On Art. As promised, we're bringing back our photography special and we bring you the best of the best from the world of photography. Our Mojato segment this week will feature Courtyard, a brand that has dedicated itself to bringing back old world designs into the contemporary age. And our upcoming event section, we will bring you all the hot and happening events around the country. So stay tuned because this is Mojato On Art. Our first stop is Goa, where we met photographers Dinesh Khanna and Prashant Panjiar, who were the curators of the photography section at Serendipity Art Festival. With a focus on Goan identity, several archival and contemporary photographs were on display. The festival also looked at bringing commercial photographs into the gallery and the exhibition space.
Dinesh Khanna and Prashant Panjiar, also known as the duo behind the Delhi Photography Biennale, curated the section on photography. Prashant Panjiar's exhibitions foregrounded Goan themes, with a tribute to another renowned photographer, the late Prabhudas Das Gupta, whose intimate look at Catholic Goa was ironically exhibited for the first time in this state. The other exhibitions made brilliant use of archival photography, with a collection from Paul and Souza, one of Goa's oldest and most prominent photo studios, and more archival sociology from a family album.
I started with an idea of looking at Goan identity in some form or the other. And I wanted to look at it from both archival work and contemporary work. And then I came across an architect, Arminius, through the person who was assisting me on the project, John Menezes,
nice,
who led me to this beautiful collection of a family album, which gave me an insight on how migrations in Goa happened to across the world in the late 19th century and the early 20th century. But the beautiful part, really, you know, look at this. This is a Goan Christian family in Karachi. But you look at the pictures and they look like an aristocratic Muslim family. You know, this thing, in Hindi we call Veshbhusha, no? You get the look of the place. Here in Burma, you know, tuck, it's there. There's a picture we didn't use in Calcutta. He looks like a Bhadralok from Calcutta. You know, it's like, that's the beautiful part of it.
Among the exhibitions Dinesh Khanna curated was one that explored the idea of Indianness through portraits. Roti Kapra and Makan was an unorthodox take on an old Indian theme, using multimedia and individuals from diverse fields, fashion, architecture and food, who emerged as artists in their own right.
Coming myself from the background of commercial photography, I've always felt that, you know, there are commercial photographers whose work comes from their own sense of aesthetic, comes from their own sense of beauty, but they are never given the artistic recognition. And I wanted to see if I could break that barrier of, you know, people who are doing commercial work, if their work can also be shown in a gallery stroke a festival space. Photographers who specialize in, say, shooting garments or shooting food or shooting interiors, who aesthetically have taken it to another level. So whether it's the aesthetic, whether it's their art, whether it's about luxury instead of this roti kapra and makan. And I wanted to see how we could turn this on its head from just being a need to being a desire.
We now move to Delhi, where Diva Gujral from Photo Inc. is going to walk us through a stunning exhibition at this year's India Art Fair.
The Me
medium of photography is evolving, and Photo Ink Gallery in New Delhi has remained on the cutting edge of what the medium has to offer. At India Art Fair, Photo Ink brought together minimalist photographic creations with rarely seen glimmers of art history and expressive flora alongside urban din.
My name's Deva Gujral, and I'm a PhD student working on contemporary photography in South Asia from the years 1960 to 1975. We're looking now at a Dutch photographer called Bas Mius. Bas Mius has been doing a series that plays with sort of still life photography inspired by the Dutch Golden Age and that sort of hyper-realism that existed in still lifes in the 17th century in Holland, and reconciling that with images of Mughal flora and fauna that one would see, for example, in the Taj Mahal, that sort of Pietra Dura work. They've been taken by creating a series of 20 or 30 photographs of these particular flowers, and then they're manipulated on a computer so that different aspects of the photographs come through. So these are actually quite sort of heavily constructed images in a series on a sort of style that's called post-production. This is specifically for sort of Mughal inspired work. So it's really, you can see a reconciliation of the two styles in his body of work. So one of the earliest styles of photography was something called the photogram. It involved using a piece of very light sensitive paper that when it was selectively exposed would leave marks on it. For example, if you left, say, a flower on this piece of paper and you exposed it to the sunlight, it meant that it would form almost a negative of anything that was left there, in this case, the flower. It's something that we see occasionally, but not very often. A very young artist called Srinath Ishwaran has started to apply it. He's born in 1989, but he's really using and adopting a form of photography that existed really from the inception of photography, from about the 1830s. This is a series of works that was created by leaving elaborate stencils on photosensitive paper and then exposing it selectively, therein creating these compositions that are more similar to minimalist painting than they are to photography itself. So one of the most interesting photographic additions to the art fair is this wall that has a series of photographs of modernist painters from the 60s down to the 80s, done by the photographer and art critic Richard Bartholomew, as well as his son, the photographer Pablo Bartholomew. We have a series of images of painters, often that have been taken first by the father and then by the son, something like 10 or 15 years apart. So here, for example, we have the painter Gaitonde, first taken by Richard Bartholomew, and then 15 years later taken by his son Pablo. Similarly here we have Jairam Patel, the prolific painter and artist, taken a few years later by his son Pablo. We see through their work a very interesting documentation of the lives of the artists. A lot of these artists' works are available and visible elsewhere in the fair, but then through these photographers you sort of are reminded of the lives that were lived with these painters.
Now moving on to our next photographer, Shellen Parker's love affair with photography began at the age of 7 when his father gifted him a small Kodak box camera. Let's take a look at all that he's been up to since then.
When you start doing photography, it's an exciting thing to see, especially when you work in a dark room, when the image emerges in a dark, this thing on a paper, it's a magical thing. Today, because of the technology change, what I can do is paint with light. Meaning, whatever I'm doing is actually painting with light, drawing with light. And the exciting thing about doing photography today is that you can see it, you can blow it up, you can do what you want, you can share it with people. I think that is where one has reached. So, any object that you take, once you look at the object, you start a dialogue with that object. And it's not something that You picked up a camera, you've taken a picture, you've got it and you run away. But here is a dialogue between the object and you as a photographer, and the light, what it does to the object. And you keep working on it, you set up everything, light it, take a picture, and keep looking at it. 2 days later, you said, no, it's not working because whatever, something comes to your mind. So you scrap whatever you've done earlier and you restart this whole exercise with the same object. I started taking images. I mean, put them in files. Shoot, put them in files. Shoot, put them in files. Over a period of a year, I found that there is something which started emerging out of it. Then I started saying, okay, this is what I like. Let me work on this particular track. So that's how most of this emerged. So I think about beginning was 2008, and I continued doing it. And maybe the last of the image I did about 6 months back, when I said, okay, now I don't like this, let me work a little more on it. And so, I mean, every time you look at something, you say, oh, at that particular time you really liked it, but now you don't like it. And here is, sometimes you can go back and do it, because I was doing it in a controlled environment, I could go back. It is not as if I was taking a picture on a street and where I couldn't go back. So that's something that happened.
Well, if you'd like to enjoy all this good weather that we've been having, here are all the events that you can attend around the country. After the break, we meet Dayanita Singh and Aditya Arya. So don't go anywhere.
Delhi. If you're looking for some old world Hollywood charm, head over to Oddworld Theatre, where Stiff Kitten Inc. is helping to revive the long overlooked and enormously entertaining medium of silent movie screenings accompanied by composed live music. They will be screening two films, He Who Gets Slapped and The Unknown. Both films will feature live composed music by Stephen K. Mumbai. If you're a Mughal-e-Azam fan, well, this event is for you. The age-old classic is being turned into a spectacular stage musical. Directed by Firoz Abbas Khan, with the glamour of Manish Malhotra costumes, technical expertise from Broadway and original hit songs, this production promises to be an exhilarating experience. Bengaluru. The inspired frame brings together four series by fashion photographer Rohit Chawla that recreate lifelike experiences of famous works of art by Raja Ravi Verma, Gustav Klimt and Frida Kahlo. Chawla has used contemporary models who are dressed in clothes by Sabyasachi and Tarun Tahiliani. And Delhi. Hiding Inside the Light features the works of South Korean artist Kim Ho-suk. The exhibition portrays Ho-suk's journey through Korea. It presents key works from his series of portraits, landscapes, animal figures and scenes from daily life, which are almost like research and provide an intimate understanding of the social, cultural and political aspects of Korean life.